slowing down computers all over the world, and it's called Flash. Right? So it's been there a long time, and the reason people use it mainly is because it's really easy to use. And you can make this sort of dynamic content on the web really easily with it, which you can't really do as easily with HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. But with the new web technologies that are coming out, it's become increasingly easy to do stuff like this without actually using anything Flash-related. Alright, so let's see if I can change the resolution here. This is kind of crappy. Do you know if this projector goes up to a higher resolution? Oh, man. You sure?
Just take it.
So, I made something called Slash. It's not quite as full-featured as Flash yet, but it's an alternative that's based entirely on open web standards like Canvas and HTML5. It actually exports itself as a self-contained JavaScript file which you can embed in another page without including any libraries at all. So as an example, let me build a small game. So the basic element in Slash is this box that you see here. You can change its color. So let's make this background nice and blue. And let's make it fill the entire screen. One thing that you don't normally do in HTML is drag and drop images, but you can actually do that using HTML5. So I'm dragging this platform in here right from my desktop. And there we have a platform. There's another platform. So that's cool. We can preview this in another window, and we can see this JavaScript. It looks kind of ugly, but if you copy and paste this into a JavaScript file, it will actually make this picture on your screen. And so that's kind of boring. Let's make something dynamic here. So let's find some clouds, put those in there. And let's see, so if we scroll down here, we can see these scripts. So if you click on something in here, you notice it gets selected with these little circles around it. And so when it's focused, we can edit the scripts for it. Now this is a really easy way to customize what each individual object does, which hides a lot of the complexities of JavaScript. So I have some prepared source code here, so I have to type it up for you. So for the clouds, it's just very simple. The clouds are going to drift across the screen. So we'll paste this in here. Every tick, that'll happen to this cloud. Every tick, that'll happen to this cloud. Then we run it, and you can see those clouds going across the screen like that. It's pretty nice.
Nice.
So now let's add a little enemy. So let's add this Goomba here, make it a little smaller. Make it move back and forth. I've got our Goomba moving back and forth here. That's pretty cool. But another big part of Flash is interaction. So we'd like to be able to interact with the scene and actually play a game. So to do that, I'll bring in another object. In this case, Mario here. Scale him down a bit. And now, so in addition to an action which fires every so often on every tick, they'll also have some events which are triggered on key presses. So you can see there are also inputs here for what happens when you press a key. So in this case, here's the key down code, and here's the key up code. And so now you can see, hopefully you can see, oh wait, I messed up. I accidentally assigned all of that to the background instead of Mario. Yeah, the background is actually an object too. So now I should, yes, all right. So Mario is now being controlled And he can attack this Goomba. Sometimes he dies if you mess up. But hopefully... let's see if I can redeem myself here. Yeah! Alright, so Goomba is dead. Awesome. So there's one more thing I'd like to show you, too. So music is kind of cool. So Flash also has like audio capabilities built into it. And it's been kind of hard to do this in HTML. But here you can just, let's see, there's this background music. We just drag in this thing into the background music, drop it there, play it again. Hopefully it should work. There we go, yes.
Good job, man.
Two bros.